A lot of people in my community asking me one question, and that is, hey, Artem, what would you recommend for me to use to learn programming as a beginner in XYZ? There's one tool that I always recommend, and that is, you probably already know, Free Code Camp. So why am I doing that? Why do I recommend that tool? Well, let's take a look at it. So when I do go into a free code camp, the first thing that I see is that it's free. Meaning that whatever it is that I want to learn, and let's say after 1 week, 2 weeks, if I don't like the platform, well, I can just quit the platform. I don't have to use it. So I'm not going to feel sorry about my money or anything like that. I don't have to worry about that. So that's one very, very cool thing. Now, the next thing that pops up is that over 40,000 students since 2014 were able to find companies at any of those FAN companies. Now, if you are a person who doesn't have any computer experience, no computer background, doesn't matter how old you are, you can still do it. And the result is telling us is that you as a person have a chance to work at one of those companies. And it doesn't take a computer science degree. It doesn't take working as a IT person for 10, 20 years. All what you need is just a little bit of time and dedication. And then the next thing that is very, very important is the certificate part. So the reason why I do recommend is because there are a lot of people, maybe that is you, you don't have a certificate, degree, diploma in computer science, in programming. So with that program, when you have a certificate and when you do go into an interview with recruiters, with other developers, you will have a proof of, okay, me as a person, I went through a specific system of becoming a developer. I went from a very, very beginning to an intermediate advanced developer in whatever section it is. And I do have a proof. And I'll show later in a minute what I mean by that, by having a proof. And you'll be able to put certificate into your resume. And of course, even besides a certificate, you can still put in projects that you are working on. And I'll talk about later in the video type of projects that you can work on. So in any case, if I were to scroll down right now, we can see right now that there are many topics that they cover for us for free. And they're not in any specific order. That is something that you can choose for yourself on what it is that you want to study. And this is where I'll be very, very careful, by the way, because let's say hypothetically, you want to become a front-end developer, right? Well, here at the bottom, we can see they're also covering machine learning with Python. Now, the question is, does it mean I need to learn machine learning as well in order to become a front-end developer? No, not exactly. You don't have to. The two of those things are completely different from each other. So whenever you are looking at any of those specific topics, before you jump into learning any one of them, make sure that you know what it is that you're learning. Make sure that, okay, I do want to be a front-end developer, I do want to be a back-end developer, or working with data analysis, or to do machine learning stuff. Make sure that you know what it is that you want to do, because each of those things will still take time. And you don't want to just sit for like a couple of months learning one specific thing, and then you realize, oh no, I spent all this time, 3, 4 months, whatever it is, learning machine learning, but all what I need to do to focus on is the front-end development, or the other way around. So then you're just going to be like really frustrated by that, and you'll feel very, very sad. So whenever you'll be learning specific things, make sure that you know what it is that you're learning. So in any case, so let's take a look at, we can see that here right now, yeah, they're covering JavaScript algorithms, front-end, data visualization, back-end, API microservices, and so on, so on, so on, data analysis. So this is all good stuff for us, because if we don't have a certificate, we don't have a degree, diploma in those things, we can absolutely get it. So let's go into, for example, front-end development, for example. So here they have a small explanation about front-end development. And here, let me just close this for a bit. Here we have courses of what the things we'll be covering. So here we have Bootstrap, jQuery, SAS, React, Redux, React and Redux. And by the time you'll get to this point, React and Redux, of how they work together, you'll be in a very, very good position. Because if you take a look into a job market right now for front-end developers, number one thing we use a lot is React and Redux, meaning that once you'll be already here and you didn't complete this specific section yet, don't worry about that, you can already start to apply for React positions as a front-end developer. You can show them as a proof of, yeah, I've covered those specific things and I'm keep on going, and very, very soon I'll be getting my certificate and those specific projects that I have already worked on. So you can start doing that right now already, little by little. So in any case, and then we can see if we scroll down, we can see a lot more sections out here. That's awesome. So let me scroll all the way up. So here we can see Bootstrap. Let me expand this window. So here we can see number 031. So I have personally completed 0 tasks in here, and there are 31 more to go. And the way they have structured this is, if you're a person like me, type of a person who likes to have an outline of, okay, where do I start and when do I finish? I wanna have those things laid out in front of me like a book, so I can know what is that I'll be covering. And that's what they do for us. So if I click on this, for example, use responsive design with Bootstrap, we can see that we have this code editor comes up. So okay, here what they do is they give us an explanation of what is that we need to do. And if we scroll down here, here what we can do is we can run tests. And here are the things that we need to be focused on in order to pass this test. So if I were to run the test right now, we can see that I didn't code anything in there right now. So obviously I'll have all access. But if I were to follow those steps, whatever that they're asking me to do in here, after I run the test, we should be able to see all check marks or whatever is I have covered. And here we can see this is the currently running tests or what is that we're testing. And this is the final result of how it looks like. So it's very, very friendly, and you can move around if you want to see the result more or you want to see code more. So it's very, very good code editor for us to work with and stuff like that. The only thing for you to focus, to take a look at into consideration is that this is more of you do it yourself type of ideal, meaning that nobody's going to be sitting here around guiding you through step through step. They did their best of teaching us of how to code here. So if you do have any questions, what you can do is, if you're stuck on a specific thing, you can always Google, navigate to some other documentation, or better yet, Free Code Camp, they do have their own YouTube channel that you can take a look at, and they have a lot of different other YouTubers, guests, guest speakers who come in and give their own video, upload their own video in there. So you can take a look at a lot of material in there as well. If I get a chance to be there, that's going to be awesome. But in any case, let me go back now. And this is how it looks like. And again, in no name specific order, if I scroll down. Okay, so remember how I mentioned that you'll be able to prove to people at the interview that, yeah, you're doing this work currently, this is what you have done right now, and this is where you're at right now. Well, here you can see that it will take us 300 hours to complete each of those specific sections. And of course, those 300 hours could be less or more, depending on how much time you're spending on the specific task, depending on how fast you can process all that information. And so if I even to go to right now, our responsive web design right now, I already tried to do one of them as an example. Take a look at how that looks like. So here we can see exact same code editor, and the way it looks like, once everything is successful. So here what they're asking me to do, I believe, is just to have like hello world showing up in the as a final result. So what I'll do here, just copy paste my code here. So again, yeah, all of my code will go into each one, or this is where I'm writing my code. And when I do or run the test, we can see that I have completed 4% in this specific section with a check mark, and submit to go to the next challenge. And the one thing is, they don't really, as we just saw, store our previous results. So even though it was showing I have completed this section before, so If you want to keep the solution for specific sections, I do recommend to download it. Otherwise, you'll have to redo the entire work you did before. It might not seem to be as big of a deal for this specific section right now. However, if I were to scroll down right now and go to a different section like JavaScript algorithms and data structure, and if I were to go to some different part of it, well, here right now we can see it's going to be a little bit trickier, right? We don't just put in hello world in there. Here right now they're asking us to do a little bit of more work. And when we run the test, we can see right now by default there is one that is already set to succeed. The rest checkmarks fail. So if this is one of the difficult topics that you'll find and you really want to keep it to yourself, I do recommend to download it to your computer so you can refer to it later. Okay, yeah, as we can see, exact same thing goes for JavaScript, where it does start off with basics first and then goes to ES6. And that is something that we do use in the field right now. I use it every day personally. So this is something that I do recommend because it does cover a lot of good background for us. Again, the reason why I do recommend is because it's free. It gives us specific things that we need to focus on, not to be overwhelmed or not to look at other things like data analysis while I'm working on JavaScript algorithms. And then I'll get a certificate for that, and I can use that as a proof during the interview with recruiters, different programmers, developers, to show them that I am passionate about programming. I'm motivated, focused, and we can see that, yeah, this specific stuff, let's say it does take 300 hours, but I'm able to prove to show that I was able to accomplish all this work under 300 hours, maybe, or even if it took me a little bit longer, it doesn't really matter, but I'm doing the work. I do have a proof compared to the person who is also like a self-taught developer, right? And they're just going online, doing all this work themselves. And now they're trying to apply it for a job saying, yeah, I know JavaScript, I know Node.js. However, they don't have a certificate. So the question is, me as the interviewer, how do I know that you know those things? I mean, like you're saying you do, and you do have a good project over there, over here. So I might consider taking you in, but having that certificate. So if you do exact same work that another person did, but you have a certificate on your resume, the chances of you going into the room on an interview with them, much, much higher. Oh, and by the way, if you're getting value out of this video right now, don't forget to subscribe and like the video. So those are the specific things, I guess, I wanted to give you of why do I suggest this tool to my students? Why do I suggest this tool to people within my community or to my friends who are not non-developers and trying to become a developer? Is because this will guide you in the right direction. You know exactly where you're standing. You know exactly what steps you need to take. And it does give you, I believe, at the end of different sections, does give you specific projects that you can try to work on. Yeah, JavaScript, blah, blah, projects. You can work on those projects. Also, I do have some other projects that you can work on. I'll leave a link to it in the description below, and I'll try to leave a card somewhere here. And those are the projects that you can work on that will help you even more to get into a room with the developers in the interview process or to get hired. But those are my thoughts on why do I recommend this tool. And that is something that I'll recommend for you as well. If you're just starting out, don't forget to like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you in the next video.